interesting thing about testing out high-performance automobiles is that you can only do it with top drivers who can take the cars right up to the maximum.
This 1967 Shelby GT500 is better known to high-performance enthusiasts the world over as the Super Snake. And it's, without question, one of a kind. For years, the debate raged within the Mustang community as to whether a factory-built Mustang had ever been powered by Ford's legendary FE Series 427 cubic inch V8. But while the answer to that riddle remained elusive, the undisputed truth of a 427-powered Mustang conclusively being built is represented by the Super Snake. A 1967 Shelby GT500, which received a 427 transplant at Shelby American's race shop in Venice, California in the summer of 1967.
My name's Carroll Shelby, and performance is my business.
Carroll Shelby, among other things, was a Goodyear tire distributor in Southern California. So when Goodyear planned to give the ultimate endurance test to its new line of Thunderbolt tires, designed for the average family sedan rather than for high-performance applications, it made perfect sense to hand the job to Shelby. The decision was made to modify a production GT500 by installing a race-tuned, lightweight Ford 427. The same engine which had provided the power for the race-winning GT40 at the 1967 24 Hours of Le Mans, driven by Dan Gurney and A.J. Foyt. The result, the Super Snake, boasting 600 horsepower, enough to make it the fastest street-legal production-based car anywhere in the world at that time. The one-off stripe treatment featuring a single wide Le Mans stripe flanked by two narrow ones also distinguishes the Super Snake from any other 67 Shelby GT500. The odometer reads just over 26,000 miles, and the Super Snake is fitted with the same, almost impossible to find, Thunderbolt tires, which underwent the Goodyear tire test at Goodyear's high-speed facility in San Angelo, Texas, over 50 years ago. They are the narrowest tires Shelby ever mounted on a GT500. And yet, the Super Snake with Carroll Shelby at the wheel reached a speed of 170 miles per hour. And following the test, the tires retained 97% of their tread life. The historical importance of the Shelby Super Snake cannot be overstated. Shelby Mustangs were among some of the rarest collector cars in existence, but fewer than a handful can be described as one of one. The Super Snake easily satisfies that description. Not only the car itself, but the immensely valuable engine under its hood, which connects directly to Ford's dominant victory at Le Mans in 1967, making the Super Snake a muscle car with very few equals.